There is certainly no shortage of Star Trek projects in development. However, there's one in particular that has sadly been ignored. One I'm sure many disenfranchised fans would like to support if it got the green light. In this video, I'd like to talk about an interview that Star Trek icon Michael Dorn recently did with Trekmovie.com regarding his Worf-centric series that he has been trying to get developed for years. Michael Dorn, who first played the Klingon Worf in Star Trek The Next Generation, revealed that long before the streaming service CBS All Access even existed, which is now called Paramount Plus, he had the idea and drive to create a Captain Worf series. When asked if he's recently talked with CBS executives about the project, he confirmed he had, but that interest continued to rise and fall throughout the years. He further added that he believes a great opportunity would be missed to insert something into Star Trek that has always been there, the Klingons. His pitch for the series sounds incredibly interesting, and Dorn already has the script written. Regarding the premise for the Klingon-centric show, Michael Dorn said, quote, "Instead of looking at the Klingon Empire from Starfleet, we look at Starfleet from the Klingon Empire, and it has been going on for decades. The Klingon Empire just can't go on. It's the Russians, basically, and they decide that they have to either die with a sword in their hands and go extinct, or change with the times and become something different. And Worf is the guy that says, we have to change with the times. That is the mark of a warrior." This sounds like something that would fit in nicely within the Star Trek franchise. Past incarnations of Star Trek were each different, featuring new settings, people, and moral dilemmas. And even though each series was unique, they all centered around a positive view of the future, where humanity is seeking to better itself through exploration, learning, and understanding. And to see that through the perspective of Worf from within the Klingon Empire also seems like a natural progression for his character. And as Dorn commented, it would be a wasted opportunity to not explore this facet of the Star Trek universe. Dorn continued to elaborate on his concept, saying, quote, "Two things happen. They start letting other races into the Klingon world, and the only way they can do that is by letting in Starfleet officers. That's sort of the way it's done. We'll let in other people, but first Starfleet officers because we understand Starfleet. They're soldiers. We're soldiers. The second thing they have to do is their resources are limited and dwindling. Because the Klingon universe is just like the Federation, they have planets and worlds and societies that they own, but they do it in a brutal way. And so they have to go out to every one of these worlds and either give them their freedom or try to work with them, which is something that's anathema to Klingons. And since Worf opened his big mouth and said, this is what we have to do, then they say, okay then, you're the guy that has to go out to all these worlds. And every world is different. Some worlds are rebelling, some worlds want to be a part of the Klingon Empire, some worlds want to be independent, and so every episode is that." Having a series with this unique setting and from Worf's point of view from within the Klingon Empire, captaining a ship under the Klingon Defense Force sounds intriguing. I can't believe it hasn't been a priority to develop. Klingons have long been a subject of fascination, as much as Vulcans in Star Trek, if not more so since their introduction as a main antagonist in Star Trek The Original Series. Dorn continues by saying that his show is intended to be Shakespearean in scope, that there are assassinations and coups and behind-the-scenes politics going on. He calls it such a great fit, and it doesn't feel like anything else that's on All Access. This sounds amazing, and I am 100% here for it. The behind-the-scenes political intrigue of the Klingon Empire is why Star Trek The Undiscovered Country is one of my favorite films of the franchise. And upon Worf's introduction in The Next Generation, his unique viewpoint was a compelling element in examining the tense relations between Klingons and Starfleet. Worf has long been a fan-favorite character, a proud and fearless Klingon warrior and Starfleet officer, both worlds comprising his identity and background, and featuring stories where he was often pulled in multiple directions. To see a continuation of his story not as a Starfleet officer, but as a captain part of the Klingon Defense Force trying to enact positive change within the Empire sounds like a concept that is Star Trek through and through. Why CBS execs haven't made this a top priority to produce is beyond my comprehension, and apparently it has been a source of frustration for Dorn as well, as he says, quote, "It's funny because it's like they are looking for something and they've totally ignored this easy path. but we'll see what happens. I don't know if it's dead or not. I have the script ready. It's on my computer and ready to be emailed to anybody that's interested. But we'll see. They have their own take on these things, and we'll leave it at that. The interviewer even remarked that Michael Dorn has the distinction of being in more Star Trek than anyone else, and the actor plainly stated his dismay and with intermittent laughter just how little that means to the folks at CBS, saying, quote, "You would think that would mean something too, wouldn't you? It's hilarious. I chuckle because sometimes I think that they are going, you know, we need something on the CBS All Access. We need somebody that's done more Star Trek than anybody. God, who do you think? What about Michael Dorn? No, he's not right." I think that's the conversation. At least I laugh about it. It really pains me how such a creative and compelling project from an icon of Star Trek, who is so driven and passionate, and who has the most experience working in this franchise, has continued to be ignored by executives. Even when asked if he was looking to appear on the new Star Trek series Picard, Dorn revealed that he has not been contacted for it. However, if he was contacted, the actor made clear that he wouldn't come back for a simple cameo, stressing his involvement would have to be meaningful for him to sit in the makeup chair for hours on end. To quote Dorn about his willingness to appear on Picard, he said, "It really depends on quite a few things. It depends on the role, it depends on how they want to present it. The one thing you have to realize is that I have to get into makeup. You are talking about 3 hours. For me to do that, it really has to be kind of worth it, you know what I mean? I don't want to get in makeup and just stand around and scowl at people." I certainly can sympathize with these sentiments, and honestly, a small appearance on Picard hardly seems worth it to me. Like Michael Dorn, I'll remain hopeful that someday soon we'll see his Captain Worf series begin development, because honestly, that would be the only future Star Trek project that I'd be super hyped for. Apart from the exploration of the larger themes of this series, fans I'm sure would love to see the continued development of his personal life. Those are just my thoughts, and I'd love to hear what you think regarding Michael Dorn's Worf series concept and his tireless efforts to get it developed. And let me know in the comments what you would most like to see in a Captain Worf show. I hope you enjoyed this video. Leave a like if you did, and be sure to subscribe for more sci-fi and fantasy news and lore. Thank you all so much for your support. And as always, have a very nerdy day.